Well, good afternoon, everyone. As we all know, we've been gone for 6 weeks. Necessarily gone, I might add, but much is stacked up. Since the Senate is in the personnel business and the House is not, we're working diligently this week on getting nominations out of committee that are important for the country that have been languishing for 6 weeks. Oversight is beginning already. Senator Alexander is going to have Dr. Fauci and others before his committee next week related to the coronavirus epidemic that we're all working our way through. We'll continue to discuss with the administration the way forward. I know many people are asking for additional legislation. I think I can speak for our conference by saying we're not ruling that out, but we think we're going to take a pause here, do a good job of evaluating what we've already done. We want to measure its effectiveness on virtually a daily basis as we move forward. I'm not ruling in or ruling out anything except to say that if there is another bill that passes in the Senate, it will include the liability protections. Based on conditions I've seen so far, what? I'm not going to make any big predictions about what happens here in the future. We may act again. And if we do, it'll be because we're taking a measured response first to what we've already done, and then we'll see whether we need to do a lot more. Thanks a lot.
We got a full house.
Good.
Packed solid.
Every seat taken. People are hurting, I'd say to Leader McConnell. People are losing their jobs every day. Small businesses are going bankrupt every day. People are getting corona every day, and people are dying every day. We can't sit here and twiddle our thumbs and say, let's wait. There are huge needs, and the failure to act will be far more harmful than acting to solve these problems. Yes,
Is that your estimation?
Yes, the state and local governments, you need huge amounts of money. And again,